President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. defends the presence of thousands of policemen in Davao City to enforce the arrest of Kingdom of Jesus Christ founder Apollo Quiboloy. He also insists there are no human rights violations, saying policemen who enter the KOJC compound were not armed. Here's the president in his own words.
Meron bang human rights violation kung maraming pulis?
Yun pong sabi nila.
I don't think so. The reason we did this was that so that we could maintain the peace. The only way to maintain the peace is to make sure that the area is safe and is secure. And considering this is a 30-hectare compound, kailangan mo talaga ng maraming tao. Hindi mo pwedeng gawin ito na isang dosenang pulis para hindi na bale yung mga lumalaban o yung mga nagre-resist nanghaharang, hindi na bale muna yun para lang yung pag-inspeksyon ng 30 hectares kailangan mo na agad ng maraming tao. I think what they're talking about is political na yan. Hindi na totoo yan. You go to any human rights advocates, nothing that we did. Lahat ng pumasok na police, hindi armado.
Canada joins the U.S. and the European Union in imposing tariffs on Chinese electric vehicles. The duties apply to all EVs shipped from China, including those made by Tesla. Canada also announced a 25% tariff on imported steel and aluminum from China. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau says the move is meant to counter what he called China's intentional state-directed policy of overcapacity. The Chinese embassy in Ottawa, meanwhile, called the move protectionist. It warns this will undermine normal economic and trade cooperation between the two countries.
Philippine Finance Chief Ralph Recto defends, before a Senate budget hearing, his agency's proposed 33.7 billion peso spending plan for next year. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual joins us on the line for the details. Jackie, what can you tell us?
Hi, good afternoon, Denise. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto defended the 33.75 billion peso proposed 2025 budget of the Department of Finance and attached agencies at the budget hearing of the Senate Committee on Finance led by Senator Grace Poe. Recto said the proposed budget is 20.8% higher than the 2024 General Appropriations Act level, but he said this will also fund a huge task of DOF to fund the country's proposed 2025 budget of 6.35 trillion pesos, of which 4.64 trillion are supportable by revenues from the Bureau of Internal Revenue and Bureau of Customs, both of which are attached agencies of the UF. He said that for next year, the expenditures are expected to amount to 17.4 billion pesos per day, and that is the task of the DOF of where to look for the money. The proposed budget will go to enhance revenue administration, improve financial asset and debt management, modernize customs, and many more. Denise, the biggest per agency, the biggest slice will go to the BIR, which is about 17.68 billion pesos, followed by the Bureau of Treasury and the Bureau of Customs. The finance chief added that the government is on track to meet the fiscal program for the year, with revenue collections already reaching 2.61 trillion pesos for the first 7 months of the year. Meanwhile, Denise, Maharlika Investment Corporation President and CEO Rafael Consig was also part of the hearing, and he mentioned that they will soon invest the first investment of Maharlika in 2 to 3 months, and likely this will go to energy projects. MIC also said that the Sovereign Wealth Fund already earned 1.5 billion pesos in interest income. And that's the latest from the Senate. Back to you, Denise.
Jackie Pascual with that report. Thanks, Jackie. Three Philippine startups make it to Forbes Asia's 100 to watch list this year. The list celebrates small companies and startups that have grabbed investors' attention and their checkbox. Among them, Lista, an app that lets Filipinos and small businesses track their spending habits and cash flows. It was recognized for raising over $5 million in funding. Mober also gained recognition for getting $6 million from a Singapore investment company to expand its fleet of fully electric delivery vehicles. and Zed also gained recognition. The first new bank in the Philippines to offer a credit card was lauded for raising $6 million in seed funding. Philippine Education Secretary Sunny Angara calls on other ASEAN member states to prioritize digital transformation. He made that call during the 13th ASEAN Education Ministers meeting. There, he highlighted the collective responsibility of policymakers to equip learners with skills and values they need to thrive in an increasingly digital world. But Angara also reminded his peers, education is still a human endeavor, and technology is simply a tool to help address challenges in the sector.